Can you answer 50 verbal, numerical, and abstract reasoning questions in 12 minutes? Hi, I'm Tal from Jobtest Prep, and in this video, we're going to talk about the PI Cognitive Assessment. The PI Cognitive Assessment Test, formerly known as the PLI test, is a cognitive ability test used by employers all around the world. The purpose of this test is to see whether you've got what it takes to perform the job you've applied for. Your eventual test scores in each of the test sections can tell the employer a lot about you, including your ability to learn, your problem-solving skills, your ability to understand and act upon specific instructions. The test consists of 50 questions to answer in just 12 minutes. The main question types appearing on the PLI test are numerical reasoning, verbal reasoning, and nonverbal reasoning. Numerical reasoning questions are used to evaluate how you approach and solve a variety of math-based questions. Questions in this section include those for numerical theories, word problems, and more. Calculators are not permitted, so before the test, make sure that you brush up on your addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, fraction, and decimals. Make sure you can make simple calculations in your mind or with scrap paper. Verbal reasoning questions are concerning analogies, antonym, and verbal logic. In these questions, if you do not know the meaning of the word, you can use the elimination method and try and see which answers are definitely not correct. Nonverbal reasoning, this section includes questions assessing your spatial, logical, and inductive reasoning ability. You should expect to answer questions in which you decipher and complete patterns, as well as mentally manipulate images. In order to figure out the patterns and relationships, look at the following features: colors, shapes, location, rotation, movement, and direction. If you can't see the pattern in a glance, pick one feature on which to concentrate and look for a rule. Most people do not complete the PI Cognitive Assessment, as answering 50 questions in 12 minutes is not an easy feat. Aspire to answer as many questions as you can. Incorrect answers do not lose you points, therefore it is recommended to not leave blank questions. If you feel like you might be stuck, take your best guess and move on to the next question. You can move back and forth between questions. This means that if you choose, you can skip questions in your weaker subject and answer all questions in subject you are confident in first. Jobtest Prep provides you with the most up-to-date practice materials on the market. Our pack includes full-length simulations with a real test time limit, complete with answers and full explanations, as well as study guides and extra practice, all geared toward best preparing you for your upcoming exam. That's it for today. I hope you've enjoyed and learned. Now it's your turn to practice. Good luck!